didn't he?
One.
Hit that sweet. Nice angle on the blue to come down for that red behind the black. Tough shot that, made it look easy. But he could have played that one better. The cue ball should have been nearer the red, although it is touching the cushion. So I would expect him to pot this. Didn't fancy it, and if you don't fancy it, don't take it on.
Mark Selby, six.
If he misses this, it could be a free ball. Yep, he'll be happy with that. The red won't pass the brown. This isn't easy. You could play the red onto the brown full in the face and screw the cue ball down the table. You could clip the red thin, but if it makes contact with the brown, it could go towards that left corner. So this isn't straightforward, this. Glide off the red and leave the cue ball behind the yellow. Using the green to stop the red going into the pocket. Hasn't quite got the snooker, but he's got it safe. Now can Jan play that cue ball in behind the green? Wouldn't be difficult to hit, but you never know. Well, too risky to take the pot on.
Well, it's turned into a tense opening frame. 27 minutes. Embingtaf 14 in front on this last red. Nothing safe, really. Other than this red at the moment.
This is a tough pot, and the double kiss is on if he plays a safety. That red just travelled a little bit too far for the shot that Mark Selby played. Hit the wrong side of the red there, and very fortunate not to have gone so close to the cushion. Another tough pot if he decides to take it on. Great pot, and should be a frame winner.
One.
Yes, terrific queuing here from Selby. The kick that Yanbingtao had earlier on was a big moment, but a lot's happened since then. And these are the sort of frames Selby so often wins, these long frames where he all gets a bit involved. There you see, coming up to half an hour.
He's got a nice angle on the brown to be able to get to the yellow, but taking the more difficult blue.
Eight.
So he's going to need down to the pink. Just win so many of these sorts of frames. I do go back to that kick that Yanbingtao had, though. He was ahead, the balls were nicely open, he looked like he would do enough to win the frame there. It was an unfortunate moment for him.
20.
Well, it's a cracking last six. Red that Selby potted, he's made the clearance to the pink. 31 and a half minute frame then goes to the world number one, Mark Selby, to lead. Birthday boy, Yanbingtao, 1-0.
Red and a blue would be enough. So Big shot this. And what made it more difficult is he knew he was leaving this red to the left corner. He'll be pleased to see that red go on the cushion or close to it.
But he won't be pleased to see Mark Selby, the master of brinkmanship, coming back to the table. Stole that last frame on the pink.
So has the angle on the blue to either play into the two reds by the pink spot or play for the two reds on the right side of the table. A little shorter pace, wanted to be straighter on the red to get to the black. And has a nice angle just to stun across for these two reds. Well, chose to bring them into play. And that's not too bad, as this red will cut to the middle. Well, that last shot there has just tied the yellow up. And just not hard enough for the black to be able to get the cannon. So I'm going to have to try and drop him behind the red. Didn't fancy the red down the cushion, so just chose to play the safety.
Well, in the first frame, there was a safety battle on the last red, which Selby ultimately won.
And that's another good safety.
Mark Selby, 32.
So, Yan Bing Tao, as you can see, snookered. He's 30 in front, so only needs the red.
Well, nearly said he'd be happy with that, but he's left the red on. very nearly got the snooker in behind the black. A chance here, and if he can play the cannon to the pink and yellow. So a half chance. Not an easy pot, but could play it with some safety in mind. Just needs the red.
Yeah, that was a definite reprieve. And Selby, you saw in his seat, disappointed there. He knows that was a chance to possibly steal another frame. Good pot. Very good pot. And now Mark Selby needs snookers.
One.
Yes, but don't think it's over. He's the best in the world at getting snookers. If I was Yang Bing Tao, I'd try and push the green safe and try and play the snooker. This is the kick that he got in the first frame. Certainly cost him the red, if not the frame. Pushed the green to the cushion. It was more important to get a ball safe there, I think.
Meanwhile, Hossein Vafai of Iran has beaten Ali Carter 4-1. That's a great result, clearly, for him. Carter, one of only six top 16 players in this round, but he's out. Vafai plays Judd Trump tonight. Selby is snookered here. He needs to snooker himself. 1 4-point snooker to tie. It's actually only the second Home Nations event he's played in. He played in the first English Open when everyone was still thinking £1 million bonus. Ducked out of Belfast and Glasgow, because it was a very busy time of the season. He was winning tournaments around that time. Welsh Open, though, is an established event. It's his first ranking event he won, actually, Mark Selby, in 2008. So although it's part of this Home Nation series, it's also well-regarded in its own right. This is the 25th anniversary, in fact, of the first one in 92 that Stephen Hendry won against Darren Morgan.
This is a little tricky, having to play it with side. Oh, well, he didn't play it like that. My word, how fortunate was that? Much as the game missed it on the way he played. Chose to play the safety rather than the pot. think it's a snooker, but not too difficult to hit.
Going back to Vafai there, I mentioned Bit Ali Carter. He finished off with back-to-back centuries. Very, very impressive. I know Ronnie and Jimmy are big fans of his.
Oh, that's a good shot. And this isn't easy to hit. I'll almost certainly leave it if it doesn't hit it.
Well, that just eases a bit of the pressure, I guess. So he's competing very well here, Yanbing Tao, with the world champion, and he should now have won his first frame. Mark Selby always makes it tough, so you've got to make it tough for him. Does play with some maturity for someone who is 17 today. He's had quite a long career already, though. I mentioned his amateur record. You know, he started very young. World amateur champion at 14, won the World Cup
40.
As well already with Xiao Yu Long when he was 15. Honours even then here in Cardiff. Mark Selby this time did not turn it round, and it's Yanbing Tao on the scoreboard, level with the world number one at one frame apiece.
If he misses his red, everything's there. Mark Selby needs blacks with the reds.
Jan Mikkel, 63.
Yeah, good 63, but he knows he's not there yet.
Yeah, he could be snookered the shot. No need to take the pot on. Well, that wasn't very far away. Mark Selby needs blacks with these reds. Well, that's a clever shot from Yang Bangto. Sending the red down the table. Much harder to get to the black from reds down the other end of the table. I think he was trying to push the black to the cushion there. And again, if he tries to send the cue ball down the table, hide the cue ball behind the yellow, he may leave a long pot on. He doesn't want to leave anything on. And Ming Tao would certainly take it on. Just needs one more red. At a good pace on the cue ball. I'm just so surprised at how knowledgeable this young man is, Yang Ming Tao. He's competing with one of the best safety players the world's ever seen. And he's only just turned 17.
Yes, this is what Jimmy White was saying. It's like watching a young John Higgins. It's not just about going for shots, it's about thinking about shots. And understanding what the right shot is at the right time.
Well, he's forced the mistake from Mark Selby. Tough pot this, but a chance to seal this frame.
Bing Taz ahead on safety success, 93%. That is seriously good, especially against Selby. Now it's down to knocking this red in, having the white clean first. You had to think about it, didn't it? But it went in.
One.
So three snookers required.
Brown.
Yes. Good choice to take the extra points. That may stop any playing on.
Five.
Still with a chance to knock the red in as well. Huh, which he's done very nicely. I'll tell you what, he's playing well now. And he's got himself in front. What were you doing on your 17th birthday? Well, Yan Bing Tao is taking the lead against the world champion, the world number one.
Nine.
Having won, it's got to be said, the safety battle there.
Ten.
Well, the bit of the tension just lifting now is some great shot making here. Game in recent times, recent months, has been dominated by the 40-somethings winning tournaments, or players just under 40 as well. But here we have an authentic, talented teenager.
25.
Showing us what he can do. So Yan Bing Tao, who lost the opening frame on the pink, has won the next two. He's competing in every department with Mark Selby, who he leads here in Cardiff by 2-1.
Ready, it's available.
It's almost like Mark Selby is finding out what it's like to play Mark Selby. Boot for once is on the other foot.
Brown. Five. Six.
Yes, that's okay. Just drop the black in and he'll have the red to the left corner. And that releases the other two reds into the right corner. So this has turned into a good chance. Now he's not quite hit that hard enough. Wanted to be straighter on the red to be able to get to the black. I may have to play a run through cannon onto the reds.
14.
A little harder would have been better. But it was a shot previous that has left him with this difficult black. Good pot, but needs another one. The crowd really appreciated this young man.
21.
And struck that one well as well. Has the angle on the black to stun for the red. Pots this red, it releases the other one next to it into the opposite corner.
29.
He needs red and a black, and Mark Selby needs snookers, otherwise he's 3-1 down. And this is a seriously impressive performance.
30.
By Yang Bing Tao. But once it's Mark Selby who's feeling it, he's being put under it. With great safety play.
37.
He wants this red to make absolutely sure. Well, the upset definitely 50. On now. He's playing well enough, not only to beat this man, but to go a long, long way in this tournament.
Yes, Mark had his chance, didn't he, when he missed that red to the corner after potting a really good blue.
Selby hasn't got flowing in the match. His highest break only 32 as that red stays out. Things have got to improve for the Leicester man, otherwise he's heading home. So Yang Bing Tao is poised to cause a big upset. He leads Mark Selby 3-1. Welcome back. So, Yang Bing Tao 3, Mark Selby 1, Chinese teenager. 17 today, remember. Needs one more frame to send the world number 1 out in the third round.
And a good break-off. Hasn't gone well for Mark Selby. He was forced into taking the red on. He was on the black had it gone in, but he has left the red. Straightforward, this next positional shot. Reds covering one another. And he's nowhere. Disappointed with that one. That's the first poor positional shot that he's played. I think he was playing for the red just above and to the left of the black. Touching ball called.
Yang Bing Tao 4.
And judge that one well too.
foul, the miss. Jan Mikhtel, 4.
Well, is it worth putting back? That's a possible red to the middle or one to the corner. He doesn't like either of them, though. Yep, back it goes. So another attempt at this four cushion escape. Cue ball has to hit nearer the middle pocket. Not quite that near.
Foul, the miss. Jan Mikhtel, 4.
And that will be going back. There's nothing on. If it's hard enough. No foul call, so
touching ball, question, yeah.
Touching ball, so stay where you were. This could be good. This could be very good. And the balls are open, so there's danger here. His escape is the three reds just below the pink, and if he catches the pink he leaves the red to the middle, and if he just hits it a little bit too high he leaves reds to the left corner. So may try and play on that red closest to the left corner pocket. Coming off three cushions, two sides and the black. He's got too close to the reds and that's a mistake. Now it's down to Jan Mikhtel. Black and pink tied up for the moment. Couldn't get the right side of the blue.
yellow.
Wow. Oh, he's fluked the yellow. And he's on a red to the right corner.
Well, I don't know about his birthday. All his Christmases have come at once here. Because that was... look, just watch this again. He got nowhere near the pot. The yellow careers into the green, goes into the middle. A couple of little kisses with a cue ball here and there. And he's on the black. Sorry, he's on the next red.
Yes, and an important red as well, because it frees the black, this red. So if he can get that cue ball out for maybe the blue or one of the smaller bought colours.
Four.
A little heavy. Didn't want to be that close to the cushion. An excellent pot from under the cushion there to pot the brown, come back across the table for this red.
Eight.
Now, will he play for the black here? It's a delicate shot this, to drop it in, try and hold for the black.
Nine.
But he's managed it, and he's nicely on the black. What a chance this is now for the youngster. Well, it's all down to him.
Not just winning, it's how you win, and what he's done to Mark Selby. Let's be honest, he's been very fortunate with the fluke here with 16. The yellow. It was a pretty wild shot on the yellow, actually, but that's gone now. He's got to focus on what's ahead, and he knows it's a good chance to complete victory. Seven. And it would be a well-deserved one. He lost the first frame largely because he was unlucky. He got a kick when he was nicely in front and nicely in. Mark Allen is out, 4-2. He's been beaten by Meiji Wen. So another upset. In a tournament of upsets.
25.
Well, all he can do is look on and hope he gets back to the table. The way that Bing Tao's playing. I don't think he will. Would have liked to have been straighter on this red. But I think 32. He can still get back to the black. Well, this is tough. Just needs to drop it in. What a good shot. And we know how tight these pockets are. That had to be in.
40.
52 points the lead. And he can get to this red. Looks good.
41.
It started with the yellow.
43.
Sweet.
He made that look easy, didn't he? I mean, that was a tough pot. Especially at this stage. So he can make the breaks. He's got a great safety game. And just as importantly, he seems to have a lot of bottle as well. Put it all together. 51. What a prospect. So here we are then. Yanbing Tao needs the black and Mark Selby needs snookers. Otherwise, he's going out. What a performance. Mark Selby, so good at getting others under pressure, has been put under it himself here this afternoon. He's not been allowed 16. To play with any sort of freedom really, despite winning that opening frame on the pink. Clear from the start, Yanbing Tao was not overawed and believed he could win, and he has done. And it's another big upset here at this year's Welsh Open.
67. 68. 75. 76.
76. I think what's been impressive is he hasn't just potted him off the table, he's used his tactical game as well. It's a great success. 83. Safety success 92% for Yanbing Tao today.
84.
This is the highest break of the match. And it could well be a century. What a way to finish.
91. 92.
Can't quite beat his highest break, which is 134. She got in the World Cup. Come on, let's see a century.
99.
99. Oh, that's a pity he doesn't finish with a century, but on his 17th birthday, Yanbing Tao gets his teenage kicks to knock out the world number one, Mark Selby. It's another big upset at the Welsh Open. What a fine performance that was from this Chinese teenager. Yanbing Tao has beaten Mark Selby by 4 frames to 1. What a great performance.